looked through the Bible this week, it's in different places. I seen the heaven and the earth created, and God did. Say, well, God used men in all the different places in the Bible. He used men to steal the waters, break the waters, part the water to the Red Sea. But even though he used man, how many of you know God did? Like Ronnie said this morning, God used the prophet Elijah in the 18th chapter of 1 Kings to bring to Ahab the fact that there was not going to be any rain for 3.5 years. And it says that the Lord's rain was stayed. And the man of God said it wasn't going to rain until I say so. But how many of y'all know God did?
That's right.
Amen. The man of God at the brook, God sent him there and told him all he had to do was stay there, and he would command the ravens to feed him. He could drink of the water of the brook while everything was dried up. How many of you know that even though the old man of God obeyed God, God did it? God sent it to a woman, a widow woman, gathering sticks. The only stick she had, the only little bit of meal she had, was to bake a cake. But the man of God compelled her to bake a cake for him, that they would not die, and she done it. She baked the cake, but how many of y'all know that the meal barrel never run out? How many of y'all know God did it?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. There come a time in this world that men were being extorted and held back. But God knew that he was going to send I'm talking about from the beginning of time, that he was going to send his son, his only begotten son, wrapped in flesh. Come on, y'all know what I'm talking about.
Amen.
Through the immaculate conception, he came into this world the same way that we did, through the birth canal of a woman. But the only difference was, amen, he was God in the form of flesh.
Amen.
He took on flesh, and he was reared in the house of a godly man and a godly woman, Mary and Joseph. God chose them out, and they raised his son. They called his name Emmanuel, God with us. How many of y'all know? Amen. And Mary had the child, the baby child Jesus, but how many of you know that God did?
Amen. Amen.
All the things that we go through today, amen, God's got men and women of God walking around, amen, and he's speaking and he's communicating to his people just like he always has. Amen. We read about Samuel, where God spoke to Eli, and he spoke to Samuel, and he moved Eli and his family out of the way. Amen. And he put Samuel, amen, in that way because the barren woman, praise God, that could not have any children, Hannah, amen, she had a son, and his name was Samuel. She loaned him unto the Lord. How many of you know, amen, that God did it?
Amen.
Come on. Amen. Praise God. Elizabeth could not have any children. Amen. But there was to be a forerunner of Jesus Christ. Amen. One to come and preach. Amen. And teach and tell the world that the Son of Man is coming. Amen. The kingdom of God is coming. He neither come to eat nor eating nor drinking. Amen. But he was born of a woman that could not have any children, a barren woman. How many of y'all know that God did it?
Yes. Amen.
In the word it said that there would be a forerunner to Jesus Christ. Amen. One of the three most prominent Nazarites in the Bible, you'll read about Samuel. Amen. John the Baptist. Amen. And in the book of Judges, amen, Samson was a Nazarite. Amen. These men of God was consecrated and dedicated before they was ever born to walk in the covenant, amen, that God had for them. How many of you know, amen, that God will keep his covenant, amen, and only God can do it.
Amen.
Praise God. I'll pray with me just a little bit this morning. I'm fixing to get right down to business. So now we see in the book of Acts where Jesus Christ has done been delivered up and done been crucified. The crowd has done called out, amen, for Barabbas to be freed and Jesus Christ to be crucified. Pilate would have turned him loose, amen, but the crowd, amen, hollered just that much more than they wanted Barabbas and Jesus crucified. We know the story, amen, that he was whipped, amen, for our transgressions. But glory to God, hallelujah, amen. They led him out of the fortress of Antonium down a sorrowful way. Amen, up to a place called Calvary. How many of y'all know that Jesus Christ was born into this world? Amen, so that, amen, the end would be, amen, a sacrifice of Calvary, that the Lamb, amen, would be slain, amen.
Yes.
Come in, praise
yes,
God. And that blood that he shed, hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Will be for the remission of mine and your sin forever. Amen, honey, you know God done it.
Yes.
Bless him, Lord. Praise God. Crucified, amen, and he showed himself. Amen. The angel of the Lord, amen, as the two women was coming to the tomb, Brother Ronnie, amen. And he said, I know who thou seek, but he's not here. Amen. Come in and look, amen. You know what they did? They looked anyway. Amen. He told them, hey, he said, look here, Jesus ain't here. Amen. But come and look. I'm telling you what, amen, I'd have probably been just like them. I'd have had to look too. Amen. Because, amen, they had never seen anything overcome death. Amen. When death come in, it was death. Amen. When death come, it was burial. Amen. But glory to God, they had seen very little resurrection. Amen. But they had seen Jesus Christ, amen, speak to the dead. Amen. The man Lazarus, amen, and call him, amen, from death. After he had been dead for 4 days, amen, Jesus spoke the words, amen, and said, Rabbi Lazarus, amen, come forth. Amen. But before he said that word, amen, amen, he prayed unto the Father. Amen. And he said, Father, I knowest, amen, that thou hearest me when I pray.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. I pray not for my own, amen, self. Amen. But I pray for these ones here. Amen. That have seen death. They've seen death take Lazarus out of here. Amen. They've seen them put him in the grave. Amen. And conceal him behind a stone. Amen. But I want you to know today, amen, Jesus proclaimed that he was the resurrection.
Yes.
And I still say today, amen, that he is the resurrection. He seen him in this world, this old wicked world, and he was tempted, the Bible says, at all points such as we were. Amen. But I want you to know the Bible says that there was no guile found in his mouth. Amen. No deceit, nor did he ever sin. Come on. Amen. Him that knew no sin became sin. Come on now. Amen. How many of you know that mine and your sins, amen, was laid on the back? Amen. Of a man, amen, that knew no sin. Amen. But glory to God, he went to that cross willingly. Amen. And then there at the end, he said, Father, amen, forgive them, for they know not what they do.
Amen.
Amen. I want you to know something today. That's only a God man, amen, that can do such as that. Amen. Take the sin of the world upon his back, and then at the end, amen, say, Father, forgive them. How many of y'all know God did it?
Amen.
I want to read you some scriptures. Y'all know this book very, got a lot of good stuff to preach on. Third chapter of the book of Acts. I want to talk to you this morning about Peter. Peter walked with Jesus, seen him many miracles that he done. Peter said that he would fight for Jesus to the very end. When Judas came to the garden to show the people where Jesus was, and when he kissed Jesus, Peter was the one that reached out with his sword and cut the man's ear off. Jesus had to rebuke him, had to hold him back. Look here. Him that lives by the sword or die by the sword. Listen, this ain't what we're doing. Amen. Whenever he said that he wouldn't wash Jesus' feet, Jesus said, amen, if you don't have me to wash your feet, you have no part with me. Come on. Peter, amen, was zealous. He was hungry. Amen, to fight. How many of you know that, amen, that Jesus told Peter before the cock crowed thrice, twice, amen, you will have denied me 3 times. Peter, in his mind, he could not believe this. Amen, but whenever he heard that cock crow for the 3rd time, amen, he remembered the words that Jesus said unto him. Come on, y'all know what I'm talking about.
Come on.
Amen. After he came back, amen, Brother Macon, after he come back into this world and showed himself to his disciples, y'all know that he told them, amen, that if they would tarry, that they would be endued with power from on high. I want you to know something today. Praise God. God's shaping things up, and God did it. Amen. He's fixing to use, amen, these 12 men that walked with Jesus. amen, to do something, amen, great. And he told them, amen, why do you marvel at this? The fig tree wither. Amen. When I rebuke it, greater things than these will you be able to do. Amen. What he's saying, praise God, if you got the power in your lips. Amen. If you got the faith in your heart. Come on now. Amen. So we know the story. Amen. That the Holy Ghost, that God had promised. How many of y'all know God did that?
Amen.
Oh, listen, you teach people to talk any kind of way you want to, but the real baptism of the Holy Ghost, amen, comes from God.
Amen.
How many of you know that it don't take long to see it impossible?
Amen.
Praise God. Somebody that ain't got it, amen, let me tell you something. Their spirit ain't going to bear witness with your spirit.
Amen.
Praise God. That was all that was for free. Now Peter, amen, they was up in the upper room. Amen. And they had prayed and God had baptized them with the Holy Ghost. And, amen. They came out and Peter preached the word with boldness. Amen. And told them, amen, they perceived that he was drunk. Listen. Amen. And Peter, amen, told them, amen, that he was not drunk. And it was a certain time of the day. Amen. But they had been baptized with the Holy Ghost. Amen. And God had given power. Amen. And John, amen, God told him, and John truly baptized with water. Amen. Jesus spoke this. Amen. But he said, I'm going to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and fire. How many of y'all believe in the Holy Ghost and fire?
Amen.
Amen. How many of you know that God done it this morning?
Amen.
Now in chapter 3, amen, verse 1, you find, amen, where John, now Peter and John went up together into the temple at the hour of prayer, being the night hour. And a certain man lame, I'm not going to preach on the lame man at the gate this morning. And a certain man lame from his mother's womb. Amen. In other words, from the time he had been born. Amen, Brother Ronnie, up until this day he had been lame. And when they laid him at whom they laid at the gate daily of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that entered into the temple. I wasn't going to read all this scripture, but I believe I will now. Who seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple asked an alms. And Peter, fastening his eyes upon him, now listen now, this is the one Peter, amen, that cut the ear off, amen, that denied, amen, Christ three times. Amen, this is the Peter that got out of the boat, amen, and walked on the water, amen, and he began to sink. Amen, because this is the same Peter. And Peter, amen, listen to this. And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. Amen, praise God. I got to go back to 4 and read that. And Peter, fastening his eyes upon him, with John said, look on us. And he gave heed unto them, expecting to receive something of them. And Peter said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, I give thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. And he took him by the hand and lifted him up. And immediately his feet and ankle bones received strength. And he leaping up, I want you to pay close attention to this, stood and walked, and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. Listen to me now. Amen. There he was laying in the gate. Amen. Had been there for a number of years, but ever since he had been born, he had no expectancy that morning or anything to be any different, but other than people casting, amen, a coin, amen, in his can. How many of you know that, amen, the world, amen, will walk by you and throw a coin in your can, amen, for a long time? Amen, but nevertheless, there he was. Amen, that man, Peter, amen, and John, amen, coming up into the house of God. Amen, they had seen Jesus Christ move. Amen, and they had felt the power of the undoing. Amen, the undoing of the power of the Holy Ghost. Amen, and they was coming up in this hour. And there this man was, and in his affliction, amen, from birth, expecting nothing new. Amen, but glory to God, amen, God had did something and transformed. Amen, these two men, amen, and made them something else. Amen. Gave them, amen, faith in their heart. Amen. It gave them a mindset to be able to speak the word. Amen. And see the word of God come to pass. Amen. There they was. Amen. And they walked by and the man begged for money. Amen. The man of God said, amen, silver and gold have I none. In other words, he didn't have any money to throw in his hand. He said, but that that I do have. Amen. Reflecting on that that came. Amen. In the day, praise God, of Pentecost. When they was in the upper room, and the Spirit of God fell, amen, inside of that room, amen, lifting them up, amen, and filling them, amen, with the power of God, amen, and they would be able, praise God, amen, to overcome the adversary, amen, and all the things, amen, that he sends our way, amen. How many of you know, amen, that it was the man Peter, amen, the one that had denied Jesus, amen, glory to God, hallelujah, amen, God done something in him, amen, and gave him, amen, the confidence to be
able to say, amen, I ain't got no money to throw at you. Can, hey, give a glory to God. Amen, as much as I have, amen, I give to thee. Amen, that's what I say this morning.
Yes,
amen, as much as I have, amen, I give it to thee. Amen, I charge you not a penny. Amen, glory to God. Amen, to preach the undefiled, uncompromised. Amen, word of God. Amen, this morning, because, amen, I know as well as Peter, amen, I'm but I'm just a man. Amen, but glory to God. Amen, God's done something down inside of me. Amen, and that world can't understand. Amen, it confines the wisdom, amen, of the intelligent intellect. Amen, it's God. Amen, it lives down inside of me. Amen, like fire shut up in my bones. Amen, I'm the well to come this morning.
Amen, and tell you God knows. I don't know what I wanted to do this morning. I wanted to set the house. Amen. I told my wife, I said, you know what? I believe I'd just sit right here. You know what? I got up. Amen. Come on, church.
Amen.
Now, if you don't know nothing about pain, I ain't got no need to even be talking to you. There is a such thing as pain where you want to just sit down and do nothing.
Amen.
Amen. If you don't know nothing about diabetic neuropathy, I got news for you, friend. It ain't your friend. Amen. Y'all pray for me this morning.
Bless him, Lord.
It ain't your friend. But how many of you know God's done it? Let me read on a little further. I'm going to get to my point. And he took him by the rag up that nine, and all the people saw this. Brother, should pay close attention. And all the people saw him walking and praising God. How God done it. And they knew that it was he which sat for alms at the beautiful gate of the temple, and they were filled with wonder and amazement at that which had happened unto him. How many of you know that in 2015, amen, when we see people healed, we see God touch people, amen, and God, amen, move infirmities out of their body, amen, God heal cancer, amen. We look, amen, at these people, amen, just like the people looked at this man that had been laying, amen, and people have been carried to the gate, amen, glory to God, amen. We look at them, amen, with amazement, amen, but yet and still we want to know, amen, where do they go to church at, amen, where, amen, did they get that healing from, amen, what preacher prayed for them, amen, what church do they go to, what denomination is it, amen, when all the time it had nothing to do, amen, when the people, amen, going up. They seen a man that had a problem that didn't have no money to throw in his cup. Amen. He wasn't desiring healing. The man laying there, he wasn't desiring healing, Sister Kathy. Amen. But what he was desiring, amen. Amen. Was somebody, amen, to throw something in his cup. Come on now. Amen. He had accepted the fact, glory to God. Amen. That he was going to be, amen, brought there to that king, and he was going to have a bed for the rest of his life. Amen. But then, amen, there come two people. Amen. God's looking, amen, just, amen, for a few people this hour. Amen. Stand up, pray, God. We use the God. Amen. Let me tell you something, amen. What you got to do. Amen. The Bible says you got to deny yourself. Amen. If you're going to pick up the cross and follow after him, amen, you'll have to deny mother. You have to deny father. Amen. You have to deny your brother and your sister. Amen. You have to deny everything. Amen. Glory to God. You're going to have to be a God chaser. Amen. And put Jesus Christ first. Amen. How many of us in this day that we live in? Amen. We want to be used by God. Amen. At the point that Peter and John, amen, and the disciples was used by God. Amen. To whatever they said. Amen. To the lame man, silver and gold have I none. Amen. He looked up and said, amen. Well, what good are you if you ain't got nothing to throw into my problem? Amen. But glory to God. Amen. They wasn't looking at his cup, but they was looking at him. Amen. And said, they fastened their eyes upon him. Amen. And he said, silver and gold have I none. Amen. But such as I have, I give unto thee. Amen. How many of us today has got enough of God in us? Amen. Or God filled? Amen. That we can touch the lame. Amen. And talk to them and tell them to get up. Amen. Or tell them that are depressed. Amen. To get some joy in our life. And they can see the power of God in us. Amen. To this say, amen. As a child of God, I'd be able to say back to him, Brother Joe, amen. It wasn't me. Amen. Why do you marvel on me? Amen. But it was God that done it.
Come on. Listen, praise God.
Peter and John were being just like me and you. Amen. They had problems with believing. How many of you here's had problems with believing?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. But now listen. The crowd, as the man that has been on that bed of affliction all this time, he jumped up and he loved on Peter and John. That's what it means. He held. He said, I'm thankful. I didn't even have no expectation of being healed today. How many people comes into the church, amen, sick and afflicted every day with no expectation of God healing? Amen.
Amen.
I know God's blessing me, praise God. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Give me enough, amen, and I'll be able to get up and come to church this morning. Come on.
Amen.
Amen. I laid in the house all day yesterday. I didn't even come outside but one time, and that was go to marry a couple. Amen. I come right back to the house, sit back down, Brother Ronnie. Amen. And just dealt with my situation. Amen. But I ain't looking for y'all to have any pity on me, because this morning, amen, I would that I had enough of God in me. Amen. And I would get up. Come on now.
Yes.
I tell you. Amen. And I'm going to go. Amen. To fulfill my obligation. Amen. And God's placed in my life. Amen. He called me to preach. Amen. And that's what I'm going to do this
come
morning.
Come on,
God. Amen. It's
yes.
God. Amen, but it was God that done it, amen. And these people, they looked in amazement.
Bless him, Lord.
Man, who made this man? Look, this man ain't never walked. He'd been nothing but a beggar. Now he's up. He's up. Amen. You know what? When he got up, Brother Ronnie, amen, he didn't run to the club.
That's right. Come on.
Amen. He didn't run back to the house. Amen. What did he do? Amen. He jumped up to his feet. Amen. Come on now. Amen. He began to say, amen. The Bible don't say that he ever praised God. He was just laying there at the gate. Amen. And God's people, amen, were just walking by. Amen. Dropping him some money. Amen. But then, amen, somebody came by. Amen. It had some power. How many of you know that God wants us to have some power?
Yes.
God wants us to realize. Amen. And we're more, amen, than just walking around here doing nothing.
Amen.
We got some power. So now listen. When he got up, he sprung to his feet. Amen. He began to praise the Lord. Amen. Thank the Lord. He followed him right on into the temple.
Woo-hoo!
Praise God. Amen. I've been bound for all of these years. I'm telling you what. All of these people that have walked by me. Amen. For year in and year out. Amen. Dropping money in my can. Amen. And finally, amen, two came. Amen. I've been baptized by the Holy Ghost. have no nothing. Amen. A lot of them ones that ain't got the baptism of the Holy Ghost. Especially now when they want to point faith.
Now I know about tongue talking, that's because they ain't got it. I don't know about all of this, but I want to tell you something. Amen. The Bible says in the last days, and I believe with all my heart, we're living in the last days. Amen. The Bible says that He poured His Spirit out upon men. Amen. Amen. Come on now. Amen. Amen. Upon men. That ain't the things that man's doing. Amen. It ain't the rock concert. Amen. It ain't the gospel concert. Amen. It ain't, amen, nothing. Amen. About anything that's going on in the church. Amen. But it's the enduring and the filling of the power of God inside His vessels that has made themselves
better. Yes,
Lord. Amen. Amen.
So they followed him right on in the temple. Praise the Lord. Oh man. People said, look at him. Amen. That was that man that was laid at the gate. Amen. I know I'd walk by him about 1,000 times. Amen. He never asked nothing of me. I went by him 100 times. He never asked me for nothing. That's kind of our excuse now. Well, they don't ever ask for nothing. Amen. He didn't ask Peter and John. Y'all read it. He didn't ask Peter and John. He just had his cup out there. Amen. Everybody coming back dropping the money. Come on now. Amen. You can go to churches in our community, all around our community. You can just go right on in, drop your penny in the offering plate. Amen. That's what you're going to get. They're going to walk right on by you. Amen. Come on, y'all know what I'm talking about. Ain't nothing going to be no different. Everything's going to be the same. Amen. But Peter and John, they fastened their eyes upon that man. Amen. He said, silver and gold have I none. Amen. We ain't going to support your problem. Amen. What we want to do is speak the word of God over your problem.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
God will go away.
Yes.
Glory to God. It takes something within a man. And I believe Peter had had it. Amen. Because he had seen Jesus. He had lived Jesus. Amen. He had experienced Jesus. And when he said, arise up, he was just thanking God. Amen. To take him and lift him up.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Now, lay inside the temple, everybody's marveling. Oh, everybody's coming to Peter and John. Oh, listen, they like gods. Amen. Oh, listen, he spoke the word. How many of you know? And in our county, amen, we got preachers. Amen. Every day preaching on Sunday. Amen. It's got the power. Amen. To heal. Come on now. Would we believe? Would we believe? The congregation. Would we believe? Would I believe for a healing for my body? I would believe. You see what I'm talking about? Would I believe? I know we got preachers, amen, in our county. Amen. I got confidence in, amen. I love them. Amen. I love them to preach. Amen. I love to listen to them preach. And I know they got the power of God inside of them. Amen. And they got the power of the Holy Ghost. And they got the power to lay hands on the sick. Amen. To see them recover. But you know what? Amen. Can you get the people to believe? Can you get the people in the mood? Amen. To worship. Amen. To praise. Amen. The Spirit of God. Amen. Inside of the house. Amen. The wicked and handsome. Amen. The Spirit and feeling. Amen. And reverence Him and praise Him and bless Him. Amen. But we can get to the place. Amen. Where the waters is troubled again. Yes. Amen. And we can see God do it.
God bless.
Listen to what Peter said. Why he marveled. And I wonder, Ronnie, if you thought back when they was with Jesus at the fig tree. And he said, why do you marvel at this? He said, it was the one whom you crucified. You delivered him up. He said, it wasn't by my holding his life. Listen. Peter said, why y'all marvel? Why y'all? He wasn't by me. Wasn't by John. It wasn't by our holiness. It wasn't by our righteousness. Amen. But it was by, amen, the holiness and the righteousness of the one that we serve, Jesus Christ. Amen. The one you crucified. Amen. But the one that God resurrected. Amen. The one that's standing in the right hand of the Father.
Yes.
Amen. The one that sent back, amen, the Holy Ghost. Amen. The one that's empowered me and you. Amen. It ain't nothing that I do. Amen. But it's all God does. Amen. To fill me with the power of, amen, of His Word. Praise God.
Yes. Hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost in here today.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. He's given me the power of His Word. Amen. What does faith do? If y'all missed it on that Wednesday night series, you missed it. Amen. What does faith do? Amen. Faith unlocks the power of God's Word. Amen. What? We have power, and I'm fixing to quit. We got power over this, the flesh. Amen. It's not really this. Amen. But it's the fleshy thoughts that is inside of your heart. Amen. I got something for you. Amen. It's going to blow your mind. I'm going to leave this with you for a whole week, for tonight. Amen. Where your treasure is, where your heart is, that's where your treasure's at. Amen. Ain't but two conditions of the heart. That's in or out. Amen. That ain't no fence straddled. Amen. You're either lost. Amen. As a goose in a 100-acre pond. Amen. Are you saved as you can get? Come on. Amen. Amen. Ain't no in between. Either your heart thinks upon the things of God or it thinks on the things of the devil. Amen. But I got news for you this morning. Amen. When I accepted Jesus Christ as my personal Savior, amen, the blood flowed down. Amen. Not the literal blood. Amen. But the faith in the blood. Amen. It shed its out and covered me. Made me white as snow. It wasn't nothing that I done. Amen. I quit drinking. I quit smoking. I quit a lot of things. Amen. But you know what? It wasn't that that saved me. It was God that done it. Hallelujah. Now what? Listen. He went on to tell them for 13 on down through about the Jesus that they delivered up and had him crucified. They didn't crucify him. God done it. He went willingly. Y'all read? Y'all know what I'm talking about. He went willingly. And now, amen, he sits at the right hand of the Father. God done it. How many of y'all know God?
Amen.
Amen. That same Spirit, when they talk about that same Spirit, amen, it's the Spirit of the Father, amen, that resurrected the Son. Come on now. Amen. How many of y'all know that the Bible declares, amen, that He made Him just a little lower than the angels? Amen. Because He took upon a form and the fashion of a man. Amen. What is this creation that God would be so mindful, amen, of us? Amen. Why? Because we were created in His own image. Amen. Genesis 1. And I got news for you today. It's God that did it. It's God that put you where you at. It's God that'll do it again. All we got to do is trust Him. Stand with us. Oh, listen. I want to let you know something this morning. We get away with nothing. You should know that. God spares us. God has heals, and He'll do it again. We all have burdens to carry. And all we can do is carry them. He said, I'll put the moral, Sister Patsy, that you'll be able to bear. And when you get to thinking, amen, you can't carry the load, He says, look around and provide you a way of escape. What better promise than that?
Amen.
Only God can do that. Amen. Only God can put the power, amen, of your intellect and of your heart, your conscience in your own hand. Amen. And give you the power to overcome. Amen. When that good looking woman walks by with the runner and says, come on, follow me. Amen. God gives you the power, amen, to keep all the water. Who does that? God does it.
Amen.
Amen. Come on now. Amen. You dirty talkers, amen, cussing and all that kind of mess. Amen. Who gives you that power over your mind to be able to conquer that? God. God. God.
who give the power to save me? God. God done it.
Amen.
God done it. God's delivered me. How many of y'all in here has been delivered by God?
Amen.
God done it.
God done it. Hallelujah.
He'll do it again.
Amen.
That's what them men will say. It wasn't by our righteousness and our power. Amen. Because listen, it was by as such as I have, I give thee in the name. What did he say? If you ask it in my name. Such as I have, I give thee in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Arise up and walk.
Amen.
It wasn't brought up the fact that Peter had denied Jesus. That Peter sunk in the water. Come on now. All of that wasn't brought up. All it was the power of God manifesting itself. And the people were amazed. Amen. And God, amen, manifesting himself. We're still amazed in 2015. Amen. But you know what? When I pray, Sister Judy, amen, ain't no need to pray if you ain't going to believe it. Amen. When I pray, amen, I got just enough sense, amen, just to believe it.
Amen.
Childlike faith. God puts in a man or a woman. God done just enough to believe that he's the only one. He's my Lord and my Savior. Just enough to believe. Rubber the boys right on. But they's coming the judgment day. For once it's appointed unto man a time to die, and then the judgment. God done it. You can't change it. It takes God to change it.
Amen.
Amen.
You can't heal it. It takes God to heal it.
Amen.
But it takes us, and I'm finishing up with this, to have the power and the faith within us. Amen. To say, look here. Don't look on me, but look on Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. The Father said it. God done it. Everything that I have and everything that I am. God done it. God